business is looking more at Asia, business on a global scale, is looking more at Asia than it has in the past. I've been a proponent of doing business in Asia since I first came out here, but I'm just a little guy. And even when I went to Davos, the World Economic Forum, Asia was almost unknown. They knew about Japan, they knew about China, and they knew about India, and everything else was a blur. That has developed so that now Europe is kind of a blur, and everybody's focusing on Asia. So there's a lot of business coming out here, both for the first time, both for as well as expanding, existing businesses expanding. With the development of the concept of the AEC, that is the ASEAN Economic Community, which comes into effect the AEC, the end of 2015. So there'll be a lot of new business coming from other parts of the world, as well as coming from within the AEC member countries themselves. So that'd be that development. We're looking at expanding into these other countries within Southeast Asia. Some countries will welcome foreign lawyers, some don't. We can go into joint ventures with existing firms or existing lawyers. And we want to stick with the law. We don't want to branch out into accounting, for instance, and that kind of thing. We stick with what we know. Well, obviously, Myanmar is the new flavor of the month. But it's there's a lot of hype, and Myanmar's got a long ways to go because it was so far behind to begin with. Infrastructure, education, it has nothing to do with intelligence. People are highly intelligent. It's just they haven't been given the opportunities to develop that intelligence to do something constructive for themselves, for their countries, for their families, other than survival. When's the best time to get in? Who knows? So we learned our lessons about being pathfinders. We'll see when the time is right. And, you know, we keep looking. And then there's the rest of Southeast Asia. Cambodia, they don't want foreign lawyers. But there's Laos, there's Vietnam, we're already there. Malaysia, they don't want foreign lawyers. Singapore, they got enough. Indonesia, maybe. Philippines, they got enough. Anti-corruption activities, better enforcement of IP laws, new anti-money laundering laws, and laws related to the environment. They're looking at the establishment of a court that just deals with environmental issues because of a growing awareness that environment is important here. The new court hasn't, you know, it's still in a talking stage because the administrative courts, which are relatively new, or say they have set up separate divisions that relate just to environmental issues. They're beginning to listen more to the voter and what are the voters' concerns? Again, on environmental issues, on water control. The floods here in 2011 were dramatic. Never has the country faced anything of that nature. The government is, I believe, trying to come up with water management schemes. And that will in turn lead to protection of industrial estates. Because what, 5 industrial estates got flooded. They can't have that a second time around. Then people will just pull out. But generally speaking, when an investor comes here, it's a love affair with Thailand. A lot of things can go wrong, and they'll still end up going right. That's Thailand. And there's one other attitude from existing foreigners that new foreigners coming in, foreign businesses, will tend to pick up. Thailand succeeds in spite of its governments. As I said, a lot of things can go wrong and things will still go right in this country. It doesn't hold true for all the countries of Southeast Asia. Getting back to the legislative question, I haven't seen that much new legislation come down the pike in the last couple of years, other than what I mentioned earlier about anti-corruption and money laundering and IP enforcement. They'll be pushed to go faster because of the AEC. They now have real competition from some of their neighbors. And there will be migration of certain professions, not lawyers. And how those professions, say doctors. Now, a doctor coming from Malaysia, coming to Thailand, will he be able to practice here? Well, under the Thai rules, he has to be able to speak and read and write Thai. Will that change? I don't know. Probably. But given time. Given time. But it's a positive outlook, for sure. It'll have its bumps. We've had political stability here now for the last couple of years. Whether you like the politics or they don't like the politics, it's been stable. And what business looks for is stability, predictability, and what are the ground rules? Once we understand the ground rules, that's fine. Please don't change them rapidly. If you're going to change, take it easy. Let us adjust. And business can succeed in any environment, provided those three criteria are met.